the noisy crowd that set foot in Sempronia.
I wish we had a way to control them. Why should they disturb our pleasant evenings?
Something much more serious soon.
As he called that Caesar. He has done no more for them than we have. His entertainments for them can hardly equal yours. And I have the wealth that he could gain from a chosen triumph.
They make good use of your wealth before he does return.
Make what good use of it?
Lend all your support to the election of the other consul, not only to your own election, that we no doubt can deal with conflict.
But what Catiline, he could easily be elected. So easily, I thought that Cicero was also standing.
Cicero with an upstart, one of his new men, a immigrant, we shall easily defeat him.
It will not be so easy, I assure you. Cicero is a formidable opponent, beyond all of his oratory.
Support your Catiline. I hope you'll not spend all my fortune, as you have your wife for years. That's for concern.
If you want our support, sure, you'll score us a little, and let us laugh at you.
You won't get far, Catiline, if you can't accept some ridicule. Cicero is a master of ridicule as well as of rhetoric. You'll find his words as sharp as any of your men's knives.
Of roses from thee.
splash among the shady walks, bordered by myrtle, box, and oleander. The rooms are rich with different marbles from Greece and Sicily, and between washes of red. There are fish pools, wombats, boltocks, and preserves for peacocks, storks, pigeons, thrushes. There I shall find some peace.
At last my waiting is done. With their support I'll get control of this city. And control of them too. What wealth and power they have. For I am born as good as they are. And they shall have my share.
Oh, why do you want their wealth? I despise ambition.
But I need it. And soon you'll find that you need it as well.
Along with me in everything. I have left
one wife, shall I leave you for another?
And how shall we little, get hold of all this.
First, you must see I'm voted consul in the next election.
Elections? So we must wait again,
and not that now. Do you think I haven't planned this? First, we must conspire within the law and elect me consul. There are other men who, as yet, I cannot mention, who will support us. The Senate is lazy and will think of a conspiracy. The army is still in Asia with Pompey. I have the support of the captains in the provinces, as well as Crassus. With his money, any man can be bought. It's almost too good a time. No one can resist us. If we keep our oath. But one thing can ruin our plot: a traitor. So I am insured against that.
Thank you. did Madame sleep well? Not while Caesar was here. Did you? Oh, yes, and to me, too. A fool, said Grover. You dreamt of night, my love. She very clever. She knows about politics, plays instruments, speaks many languages. She's pretty.
It is said, though, that you are heart of many of
I I cannot tell.
Catiline!
Yes,
winter. You
little to you, as you have heard me speak many times as consul. I shall ask Cicero to address you.
A new consul, Cicero!
And for the last time you'll hear words. for me.
This world with time is burning.
Get what you want to give me.
see.
Today, it is the liar who wins, as you had better learn, or give up your life in politics.
Oh.
which was
violence wisely, or you may end with nothing.
cunning and smart with all his words and lies.
Do
you think he would stop me? He reads all that letters, the men will receive their orders. We shall begin tonight and wait no longer. Supplies will be stopped. Then Popish children taken hostage. There will soon be panic and a massacre. I shall then leave Rome to lead my troops against this city. But before that, the consul Cicero will die!
Cicero will die! I have committed to you now, but every day I grow more afraid.
Thank you. Your hands, nor a private house cover up. your conspiracy.
Conspiracy.
What has he discovered?
Conspiracy.
He must know about the meeting.
Conspiracy.
Admit that you're guilty, Catiline. I have already found you out. First your assembled armies, and now last night's meeting.
What does he know? Who is Savior?
Once he's alone, tell us everything.
As you will not admit your guilt, then I shall come to it. Conspired with you last night, are sitting here among us in the cellar.
How are you here in this house?
Indeed, among us here. Last night you arranged to start fires all over the city, to spread panic, to seize on these children. And then with her army to massacre us all.
Stop
us! But you stayed in time from an informer among you, and this prevented your attempt to murder me. I see you wait for me to say it. Look round for an answer. Their silence is the verdict. Get out of our city.
Such empty words from this vain little orator.
His words are sharper than your knives.
Why make such a giant of this petty politician? This upstart can't save the Republic for you, Cato.
Before you speak of death,
inventor to exile these men from home and confiscate their property and goods and start up violence again by killing them. What they used to conspire, they have not taken lives for damaged property. They did not kill. Oh, let us spare their lives. Not when later if they cause the deaths of other men, we did not kill. Such a rash decision may be turned.
Thank you.
Caesar go.
Cicero, you can't say that. Everything is there concerning Caesar. Crassus, Centralia, everything.
I say, let Caesar go.
The Senate House, and Romans have shed Roman blood. Well, this end. Shall we live in fear of these men? Shall they make us tremble in the Senate that fall? Is this the Republic the world looks to, for example? Way too late we'll realize that life has hardened, that thought and the spirit are not. And the death of free thought and action, as if the night and air of spring had failed. That would be the death of what Rome means to us. Rome is more than the sword.
It is the Senate's choice, it is the consul's. shall tell the people later that they are dead.
Yes, sir, this is murder!
And destroy it.
Is it not enough that you are exiled? Will you not destroy the Republic? Why can't you see the folly of
all this violence? Why? Because deep inside me lies a will and a lust to possess this state. And if I must, I shall destroy it. Yes, the same hatred I saw as they threw me out of the Senate. Their hatred is no better than mine. And multiplies and infects us all. This violent force which haunts our lives can never be trapped. I am committed to this force and I shall never break my oath.
I shall never understand you. You are an outcast. You can come back. I thought I dreadful they have informed against us. They have told everything to Cicero. It is true, have no doubt. My brighter maid often enough.
Where are they?
Quintus is dead. Vernon in the Senate for his services. Fulvia, hear on her way here. I told her that it was urgent.
She shall not enter this house.
She will.
What has happened?
Listen
to the urgent message.
Where is Quintus?
He's in the Senate.
In the Senate, as you would say, but dead, I'm dead for your murder, for his reason work. And this news you need not take to Cicero.
Cicero! What have you found out? Help me!
my last papa. He is the honest man. I am the liberator. Those were our masks, nothing more. Only sister challenge me, he alone defy me with his dream of the Republic. But the Romans do not think that force and violence will end in me. When will empires and triumph by force and arms, by death and violence? Then the men of peace will come, like Cicero, with their speeches and politics, only to drive the world once again to war. And once again we'll be ready for our wars and violence are indispensable to men. Lost into inferno.